Now it's your turn to write the letter L.
Can you write the letter L?
Like most parents, Kimberly wants her two daughters, Alexis and Alana, to grow up to be successful, happy adults. And since success is often determined by one's level of intelligence, Kimberly's not wasting any time in encouraging her children to watch, listen, and learn.
I try to facilitate learning in my child by reading to them as much as I can, sitting down with them and writing numbers out for them.
Man.
Reading to her daughters has also become a part of this family's daily routine.
My eldest Alexis, who is 5 and a half, she's a much better visual learner. She likes to see flashcards, and she likes to read a lot of books with pictures in it so she can get an idea of what it is.
One. Two.
But books and flashcards are not the only way children learn. Kimberly has found that everyday experiences can be educational too.
Exposing them to many diverse environments, whether it be taking them to the zoo, going out and picking flowers, running with the lizards in the yard and counting them as you go.
But is there a point to facilitating learning in your children? Or is intelligence predetermined by genetics?
No, she can print her name. She's 5 years, she can print her name.
According to pediatrician Dr. Asaka Wijitalecki, you can make your child smarter.
We know that the DNA, the genetic material, has a certain influence on the development of the brain. But it is shown that the environment probably has a greater role.
So what's the most successful approach to early childhood learning? Let your child set her own pace and have fun at whatever she's doing. Don't drill her on letters, numbers, colors, shapes, or words. Instead, encourage her curiosity and tendencies to explore on her own. Read her books that she enjoys, but don't push her to learn words. Provide her with educational experiences, but make sure they're also entertaining.
Can you count some apples for me?
1, 2, 3, 4.
4 apples.
Since the environment plays such a big role in your child's development, parents can incorporate activities into their child's lives to encourage them to learn and increase their intelligence level. Dr. Wijitalecki says one such activity is listening to and creating music.
If you take music, for example, music has an effect on making better connections in the brain. If you obviously listen to a lot of music, more connections are made in the brain, and there's information stored, and the brain develops better pathways.
Here are a few more ways to increase your child's intelligence. Read to your child as much as possible. Reading can improve your child's communication skills, listening skills, and vocabulary. Introduce your child to new experiences. Street smarts are just as important as book smarts when it comes to raising an intelligent child. Integrate learning into everyday situations, such as using mathematics to measure ingredients while baking a cake. And never force your child to learn before they're ready.
To the flag. Do you see the flag? It's a pretty flag, isn't it?
It's red, white, and blue.
While all children have the natural capacity to learn, the American Academy of Pediatrics warns parents not to push their child to read or write before she is ready. This could interfere with her natural enthusiasm to learn. Instead, like Kimberly, focus on providing your children a safe and supportive environment for learning, free from pressure and unrealistic expectations.
And justice.
And justice.
For all.
For all.
Good job.